Hello, my name is Billy Carando. I'm a senior Java engineer 3 here at ACME Soft. My responsibilities are primarily in performance and runtime issues, or as the CEO likes to put it, making our applications share schnell.
Schnell.
So now that Peter has finally upgraded to JDK 25, I can start taking advantage of Project Leyden, which should improve the startup and warm-up performance of our applications. So, I've been following Project Leyden since 2022, when the founding document was published on OpenJDK. The document outlines the major goals of Project Leyden, improving startup and warm-up performance of Java applications and reducing memory footprint, though the memory footprint goal is on the back burner right now. However, there is one overarching concern that JDK engineers have while working towards fulfilling these goals, and that is preserving Java's natural dynamism. During runtime, the JVM is able to on-the-fly generate classes, perform reflection, and make performance optimizations with the JIT, and more. Many libraries, frameworks, and even the JDK itself utilize the class generation and reflection. They are key features that have made Java such a flexible platform. And the runtime performance optimization is also key towards allowing Java applications to have throughput performance comparable to natively compiled applications. It's why we at ACME Soft chose to develop on Java. For a long time though, startup and warmup weren't that important of metrics. We at ACME Soft, like many other Java shops, were writing applications in the monolithic style and only deploying a few times a year. Startup and warmup don't matter a lot when your applications might be running for months on end. But then, in the 2010s, ACME Soft followed the craze of rewriting everything as a microservice and even later writing some serverless functions, pushed by those oh-so-smart consultants. And now we are doing multi-deployments every day, and startup and warmup are really important metrics towards making our applications schnell.
Schnell!
Only when I started digging into the performance did I realize how much is happening during the startup and warmup phases of the JVM. When you run Hello World and get an almost immediate response, you think most of what is happening is just the io.println in Hello World being executed. But if you run it again with the xlogalltrace command, you get a flood of logging statements. A lot happens during JVM startup. If you'd like to learn more details on that, you should watch this truly amazing video on JVM startup. What's important here though is that all this work increases quite quickly as you move from a trivial application like Hello World to a more real-world application like what we write here at ACME Soft. And farther, this work is repeated every time you start on one of our applications. It all seems rather Sisyphean to do all this work only to throw it all away on shutdown and then have to do it all over again. But in this, there's an opportunity for improvement. But before we get to that, let's get a bit of a baseline. Using the Spring Boot Pet Clinic application, we can start it in about 2.65 seconds. And if we throw some requests at it using the OHA tool, we can process about 7,000 requests in 5 seconds. Woo! That was a lot of work, and I'm feeling a bit hungry. Let's get some lunch ready. So I mentioned in the previous section that the JVM does a lot of work at startup. Class loading, linking, and a number of other steps. And then during warm-up, the JVM will be monitoring the application for the most frequently executed code paths, which can then be optimized by the JIT. Well, all that work still needs to happen. There is no free lunch. The trade-off Leyden makes is time shifting this work from the runtime of the application to the build time, and it kind of relates to leftover food. Rather than going through the process of making some orange chicken, cooking the rice, breading and frying the chicken, making the sauce, after doing that work the first time, I could save that work and just reheat it later, doing all the important work ahead of time. And that is how Leyden works. We would execute a training run of an application and then store that information from this training run in a cache to be used on subsequent startups. To do this, you would start your application and include the command AOT cache output with the name of your AOT cache. Being able to create a cache in a single step is an update in JDK 25 with JEP 514, which improved the ergonomics of creating and using an AOT cache. Ideally, your training run should try to closely emulate a production run, as that would provide the best information for the cache. In my case, I will simply repeat the steps from the previous section, starting up my application and using OHA to simulate load. With that complete, I will go ahead and shut down the application, and this starts the cache creation process. Now, if I run the application again, this time with the JVM command AOT cache, pointing to the cache we just created, it starts up in about 1.76 seconds. And if we run the OHA test again, it completes about 8,500 requests. For the improvements in startup, most of that is a result of JEP 483 ahead of time class loading and linking, which was delivered in JDK 24. And the improved throughput is from JEP 515 ahead of time method profiles added in JDK 25, which allows the JVM to start the process of optimizing code sooner, warming up faster. Of course, the specific improvements you will see will vary depending upon your application and how you design and configure your training run. Still, you should see a pretty decent performance improvement in startup and warmup by just adding some modest complexity to your build pipelines. All right, let me go ahead and heat up my lunch now. So what does this look like in the real world? Well, like most companies nowadays, we here at ACME Soft deploy our applications in containers. So operationally, it would make the most sense to include the AOT cache within the container image. That way, everything is within a single contained artifact. Though we might explore some other options like putting the cache in a shared volume. For building the cache, we will initially do that with artificially created training runs, but might also explore other options like doing a canary deploy as our training run, as there's no better way to simulate production than, well, production. This is a relatively new area in the Java ecosystem, so best practices will no doubt evolve over time and with experience. All right, so I have a lot of work ahead of me. Updating our build pipelines to execute training runs and add the caches created to our container images and making our applications more schnell.
Schnell!
While I do that, Anna will be busy herself making her applications more secure by taking advantage of the new and updated security features in JDK 25. But we'll be talking again soon enough when I cover the other performance and runtime features that have been added between JDK 21 and 25.